Yes, I'm talking the subject called deliverance of offended mind. Deliverance of offended mind. People are easily offended. There is a demon called offended. When this demon is programmed in the mind of somebody, it could make them the person to miss good things. Because this person is there, but immediately when he hears something, he takes it personal. Something which is just outside, that the person always takes as a personal. You don't need to take things as personal. That's why many people suffer and lose jobs, lose good things because of this offended. When you are with a group of people, you hear somebody talking, then you take it very fast. You take it as personal. So I want to counsel you by the power in the blood of Jesus Christ. Let that demon, let the enemy that is programming offend demon in your mind to die. I destroy that demon from your mind. I destroy that demon from your heart. Because once that demon has been programmed by that devil, even if you hear good things or bad things, you are always easily offended. You get offended very quickly, very easily. We were talking about the people who are offended. The Bible says in Matthew 24, verse 10 to 11, the Bible says many, many people, and then many will be offended, will betray one another, and will hate one another because of this offended. And then verse 11 says, the false prophets will come, will rest and deceive many, even the chosen one. So Jesus said, because people are easily offended, then the false prophet will come and deceive you. Now look at what Jesus was saying. In the book of Matthew 15, verse 12, the Bible says, then his disciples came and said to him, do you know that the Pharisees were offended when they heard this saying? You know, the Pharisees were offended because of Jesus. Jesus was telling them, I know the prophet is not respected. Let's look in that scripture more. Verse 11. Matthew 15, verse 11. I want you to see why the Pharisees were offended. Hallelujah. This is a very serious matter. Because people like to be offended from nothing. You have not done them anything. When you tell them the truth, that is what they don't want to hear. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. And let's look from verse 10. Then Jesus called to the crowd to come and hear. Listen, he said, and try to understand. It is not what goes into your mouth that divides you. You are divided by the words that come out of your mouth. Then the disciples came to him and asked, do you realize you offended the Pharisees by what you just said? So Jesus said that, you know, Jesus told them, listen, it is not what goes into your mouth that divides you. It is not what goes inside your mouth that divides you. It is what comes out of your mouth. It is what comes out of your mouth. When the Pharisees heard so, they were offended. They take it personal. And Jesus was helping them. He's helping things that goes in your mouth. It goes to stay there. That's why James was saying, be quick to reason, but slow to answer. Don't answer, don't talk. So people who are their mind is being offended, they are the ones who are very quickly offended. And now, if you look at that scripture, you can see what the Bible is talking about. Then Jesus told them, that's okay, let them be offended. But the truth of the matter is that, hallelujah, praise be the name of Jesus. So Jesus, when he was talking to these disciples, Yes. It is not what goes into your mouth that defiles you, but rather what comes out of your mouth. So even James warned them, said, yeah, listen, hear things, but be quiet. Just, you don't have to talk, because if you hear something, it entered inside you, it will not defile you. You just stay with it. But when you start bringing out, it will defile you. Now, people, they started irritated. They started having problem and started talking to themselves. Why is he talking like that? Why is he talking like that? And then they were offended. Then the disciples of verse 12, you can see here, then the disciples came to him and asked them, do you realize you offended the Pharisees by what you have said? So the disciples confronted Jesus. The disciple told Jesus, do you realize? Can you see that you are offending people? Talk properly. You don't have to talk like that. People are, and then Jesus said here in Matthew 24, verse 10 and 11, Jesus told them that you people look at this. Jesus told them that, and many will turn away from me and betray and hate each other. And many false prophets will appear and will deceive many. You see, Jesus tells them, don't worry, many people, thousands and thousands, will be deceived, will be offended. But there is a false prophet who will rise up and deceive people. People who are likely to be offended, they will be deceived. Because somebody will come and go with their ways they want. They don't want to hear anything like that. Do you know the false prophet out there are deceiving many, even the chosen one? You find a very anointed person has turned themselves and follow the false prophet, and the false prophet knows what the type of a person is, and then he go and lay hands on the person, and they train everything from the person. Now the person has left without anything. Jesus warned them, to say, your mind is being damaged. Your mind is being offended. You need deliverance. You need the deliverance of your mind to be delivered because of offended little things. You need the deliverance so that you cannot be offended. You need the deliverance so that your mind cannot be offended. Because this mind has been, the enemy has programmed something in your mind that makes you to be offended easily. People, I was talking with a person. I saw this person. It's wrong. And I was trying to correct the person. So the person was telling me, are you charging me now? I said, no, I'm not charging you. But the truth of the matter is, I need to correct you so that you can get the blessings of God. So the person was offended and they never called me back. He said, okay. And I know that that is the end of it. But we need to help people. I'm a counselor. I'm a satisfied counselor. Yeah? I am a deliverance minister. I am a prophet. When I see some things, I have to help you. When I ask you some question, I want you to volunteer to give the information so that you can be set free. It's not that I am charging you or I'm condemning you. The Bible says, if you believe God, the Bible says no, there will be no condemnation to those who believe in Christ Jesus. But when your mind is being damaged, being damaged, you will be offended very easily. When somebody is talking something good to help you, or you just take it personal, then you feel it, you give up very easily. Look at this man. This man was Jesus was counseling the rich man, the ruler. He was the ruler, the rich man. He was a ruler and a very wealthy man. He was a young man, very wealthy, and he was a ruler. When Jesus was teaching, he was talking about divorce. He was talking about children. If you read the book of Mark 10, you see the whole of it, you see the deliverance that Jesus was giving people. Jesus was a deliverance minister too. Jesus was a healer. Jesus was helping casting out demons. So the means of Jesus was helping and destroyed the work of the devil. Now, when he was teaching all this, the people were listening, were looking at Jesus. Now, this young man, a very wealthy man, and a ruler, was listening in very keen. And and the Bible says in verse 17, Mark 10, verse 17 to 28, the Bible says, "And now, as he was going out on the road, as Jesus was going out of the road, one came running. That was a rich man, a young ruler, coming, running, kneeled before him and asked him, 'Good teacher, what shall I do that I may have the eternal life?'" So this man, he ran to Jesus, he kneeled before Jesus and called Jesus, "Good teacher, what must I do to help the eternal life?" So Jesus looked at the man, says, "Man." So Jesus said to him, "Why do you call me good? Jesus asked the man, "Why are you calling me good? You know, no one is good but one, that is God." So Jesus told the man, "No one is good but one, that is God." Because Jesus was telling this man so that he would put his mind that God is the only one who is good. Jesus, he was like, is a human being like us, and he's living in the world. So he told this man, he was directing this man to God. Now, the Bible says, you know, Jesus tell him, "You know the commandments. Do not commit adultery. Do not murder. Do not steal. Do not bear false witness. Do not defraud. Honor your mother and father. Honor your father and mother." Now, he answered and he said to him, "Teacher," he called him teacher, "all these things I have kept from my youth." So Jesus said, "Do you know 10 commandments?" The man says, "Yes, I know them. I don't do that. I don't fornicate. I don't steal. I don't give lies. I don't lie. I don't cheat. All my wealth, I got it in a genuine way. I work so hard. I acquire my wealth. And I'm a ruler. I rule good. I don't get bribed. Nobody's bribing me. I am doing everything right. I love my parents. I love them. And I go to church. I do everything right." Now Jesus looked at the man. Then Jesus looked at him, loved him, and said to him, Jesus looked at the man, he loved him, because the man was genuine and was honest to Jesus, and everything he said was true. He didn't lie to Jesus, and that is exactly what this man was. Now the problem is, and he said to him, one thing, look at that. He said, "One thing you lack, go your way, sell whatever you have, and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. And come, take up the cross and follow me." Now, this rich man, when Jesus tell him that you lack one thing, he was offended from the top of his head to the nail. He felt so bad. He said, "Jesus, the way I love people, the way I am doing things right, and you want me to sell my property to give to the poor? Jesus, you want me to become poor? Why are you asking me to give my money to the poor? Let the poor die. Let the poor suffer. I'm not going to give anything to the poor people. Let that heaven stay. Let me go to hell." You know, the person decided to go hell and leave this. You know, this wealthy, he will leave them on the heart. It's not going with them. But to give the world the poor who are suffering, who do not have anything. He has billion money in the bank. Billions. 10 billion. 5 billion, 6 billion. And the people, the whole world, the people, the whole world, the heart of God, we are 6 billion. And here is somebody who having so much billion of money. Even if we take 1 million, 1 billion, and give it to the poor, what will it, can he feel anything? But because of that, he was offended. And the Bible says, but he was sad at this word, and he went away sorrowful, for he had great possession. He was so mad. He felt so bad. He was sad. You know, he was happy. He was that he's qualified to go to heaven. But he was so mean. He doesn't give his tithe and offering. He doesn't help the poor. He wants to take things from the poor. He could rather see the poor is lose his house, is lose his property. He could like to go and buy when the auctioneer is coming to auctioneer the house of the poor. He's coming to buy that house. That was his joy. He wanted to go and see the poor losing everything and grab them. That's what he intention. He didn't care about the poor. He doesn't care at all about the poor. Because if he loves the poor, he could not go away. He could say, okay, Jesus, how much do you want me to give the poor? Because always God talks to rich people. God does not talk to poor. He always talks to rich people. Then Jesus said, I'm telling you, Jesus said, with God, all things are possible. With God, all things are possible. Then Jesus looked around and said to his disciples, how hard it is for those who are riches to enter the kingdom of God. People, many riches, many, many, many riches, they worship their riches. They don't care about the poor. They don't care about God's people. That's why Jesus was telling this rich man, it's only God who is good. Because the rich people, they don't care about God. So many rich, wealthy people are billionaires, trillionaires who love God. They don't. They don't. If you tell them, give 1 billion to the poor or build some churches, they will not accept you. They can even kill you. Now, this man lost the kingdom of heaven, lost heaven and went to hellfire. He was sad. Then Jesus said, no, the rich person will never enter the kingdom of God. If he can enter, then the camera will enter the eye of the needle. You see, Jesus said, to God, all things are possible. To God, all things are possible. God can make somebody to pass the eye of the needle. The nitro. Is it the nitro or the needle? Yes. God can make things possible. To God, it is possible. Our great, our Father, our God, our Lord Jesus Christ, our Father of the Lord Jesus Christ, our God, God of Abraham, God of Isaac, God of Jacob, is able to do miracles. Nothing hard, nothing difficult to God. He can make you to become wealthy. He can make you to become rich. But rich without Jesus, it is impossible to enter the kingdom of God. Jesus was wealthy. We have people who are very wealthy, but they love God. But those people who are worshiping money, worshiping their wealthy, it is very difficult to enter the kingdom of God. So the disciples, because when they look at themselves, they said, my God, we are wealthy. So Jesus, why are you talking like that? And then the disciples were astonished at his words. The disciples were also offended. They were offended, saying, Jesus, why are you talking very hard words like this? Why? What's wrong with you, Jesus? But Jesus answered them again and said to them, children, hear hard it is for those who trust in riches. He said, Jesus called the disciples, children, you know, Matthew, other disciples of Jesus, they were older than Jesus. But Jesus called them children. How hard it is for those who trust in riches to enter the kingdom of God. It is easier for the camel to go through the eye of the needle than for the rich man to enter the kingdom of God. And they were greatly astonished, saying among themselves, who then can be saved? Then Jesus, then they said, who can then be saved? If that is the case, that these people cannot enter the kingdom of God. I cancel so many people who said, I don't want riches, I don't want anything to have money. I don't want money because I cannot enter the kingdom of God. Before, when I was back home, when I was in Catholic, my background was Catholic and then Seventh Day, because I was wondering to find out the truth. Now, we were told that, you know, the rich people cannot enter the kingdom of God, so you give your money, your 10 cents, that's when you can go to the kingdom, you can enter heaven. So I knew that I don't need wealth, because if I get wealth, I can't go to heaven. That was a lie. Jesus did not mean that. People who are trusting wealth, who are worshipping their wealth, who kill people to get wealth, who sell souls of man to get wealthy, who sits on poor people, who step on poor people, who make the poor people to their mad food, who make them to suffer hard labor, they pay them penny, they use the people to get wealthy, they sell souls, their souls, they cannot enter the kingdom of God. Now the disciple says, but Jesus looked at them and said, with men it is impossible, but not with God, for with God all things are possible. Then Peter began to say to him, see, we have left all and follow you. So Peter wanted to defend himself, says, Jesus, we have left everything to follow you. You mean that we cannot enter the kingdom of God? You are the one who made me rich. You know, Peter was a fisherman. When Jesus told him, go and fish there, and he got a lot of fish, he was able to sell the fish and become rich. So he started following Jesus because he saw that Jesus is money, is everything. Now he was saying, look at what you have done. Now what will happen to us, Jesus? But Jesus told them that if you trust your wealth, you cannot enter. That is sorry. That's why he said many, many people would be offended. So when the disciples saw that, he said, okay, we better stay there, and these things, it cannot affect us. Therefore, any demon, any power, in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Jesus, we thank you. Lord, we bless your name. God, you are wonderful. You are what, God? I love you, Jesus, because you are God of God, God who help people, who deliver people. You are God. Father, I want to honor you because you know our life. You know our hearts, Lord. My Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. Deliver our minds. Deliver our minds from this demon of offend. Demon that makes people to be offended. Lord, deliver them. Every power of darkness that has made people to miss the kingdom of God, of heaven, because of what people says, or because of money, or because of wealth. If you are so poor, the Bible says also, the poverty is a curse. So if you are so poor again, you will be cursed. God does not want anybody to be poor. But God wants people to be wealthy, because the Bible says in the book of Deuteronomy 8 verse 18, is his power to make you wealthy. So when you become wealthy without Jesus, without God, then it is impossible. It is impossible for you to enter the kingdom of God. Therefore, people of God, I pray that any word that make you offend, let it be melted by fire. Anything that has offended you, I pray that God will deliver you. God will deliver you. In the name of Jesus, I pray that God will deliver you from anything that is offending you. Anything that makes you to be offended, let it be dried up by fire. Let it be destroyed in Jesus' name. I pray that the blood of Jesus to wash your brain, to wash your mind, and destroy anything that is been offending you. In the name of Jesus, let's pray and ask Jesus to forgive us anything that has been offending us. In the name of Jesus, ask Jesus, Jesus, please forgive me. Forgive anything that has offended me. I'm not going to be offended. I declare a war against this demon of offended. I am not going to be offended. Whatever it is, I will work out. I will stand against it. In the name of Jesus, anything that would offend you, just do it like this, like mosquito. When mosquito is ringing on your ears, you don't stop what you are doing. You just flush it. That's what Jesus said. The thing which goes in your mouth as no problem, but the thing which comes out is a problem. It will defile you. Therefore, anything that come out to offend you, anything that will make you to cry because somebody has said something and these things has, is offending you, you go home and cry, cry, cry. And then you feel so bad. You feel so rejected. I command them to die. I destroy them. I bind them. I render them powerless in the name of Jesus. My Father, my God in heaven, I want to thank you, God. I want to bless your name, and I give you all the glory, Jesus. My God, deliver your people. Forgive your people. People who are getting easily offended, God. Deliver them, God, from the powers of the devil. Deliver them from witchcraft that is programming this demon in their minds, God, my Father. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, my God and my Father, I praise your name. I thank you. I give you all the glory. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Thank you very much. God bless you. I have to stop here. Tomorrow, we will have prayer and fasting for 3 days for singles. If you are a single person, you are looking for a partner, you join us. The number for prayer line is 712-77-57085. After this, I will pray for individual. I'm going to pray for some people. I'm going to put some prophetic word in your spirit. So you need to join the prayer line. If you don't have a long distance, I will try to put Ustream, and you can watch me from Ustream. We will be on Periscope. But because there will be a lot of prayer, I may not be in Periscope. You can see how destruction is. This is prayer and fasting. So the destruction of this Periscope, we will not tolerate it. We have to go to use prayer line or use stream. We will use everything that because it is going to be a lot of prayers. And the month of June, we are going to pray 7 hours nonstop. And fasting is coming. Our ministry is based on deliverance, spiritual warfare, and we are based on prayer and fasting. That's how we survive. Otherwise, we can't do anything without prayer and fasting. Therefore, I am telling you, share this to your friends, to people. There's a video already posted. I've seen so many people have liked that video. I have seen a lot of people have liked that video. So go tomorrow. Today, tonight is your last meal. Then go, if you can pray and fasting, try fasting, do so. If you cannot, pray up to from midnight to 12 o'clock. You break your fasting, but don't break with a lot. Break with the vegetable soup and then continue. Get something little to push you to 6 o'clock or to go to 3 days dry and fasting. If you can drink water, drink water. It depends on your condition. Don't say that I'm saying you pray and fasting so you can be fasting and then you suffocate yourself. You starve yourself. I'm not telling you. If you have any issues of doctor, sickness, diseases, don't fast. We will fast for you. And let me know so that I can fast for you. If you have any prayer request, this is the time you can email me. You can contact me to stand with you. I have seen people have started calling me right now. They want to know. And I will have special prayer for those people who are looking for partners. The Lord must answer us. You've been single for long. We are going to break that pattern. That the enemy that has been holding you single shall be destroyed in Jesus' name. We are going to bear that demon. That's why I'm coming to you to pray with you. And God will help you in the name of Jesus. You've been single for a long time. You don't need this. You call me. Our cell phone number is 647-608-5207. Also, we have our landline is 905-4877-196. Free line. If you don't have run long distance, you can always reach us. But tomorrow, you only call the prayer line, or you can call the prayer line. The prayer line is 712-775-7085, code number 595119. access code number for the prayer line is 595119. So if you can call the prayer conference, that's fine. If you cannot, you don't have long distance, I will see if I can turn on Skype. Or you call me and we see how it is going to work. Before I come, it will be midnight, tomorrow midnight. During the day, I'm going to come and advertise this. Make sure that everybody's going to join us. This will be very powerful. The Holy Spirit gave me this message, and I have to pass it to people, to single people, to single people who needs partners. If you are engaged, if you are want to get married, you must join these prayers. You need a lady person. If the partner, after the prayer, the partner will say bye-bye, thank God. Because you will not, that's not your partner. You might have love right now, but you have a wrong one. Yeah? Tomorrow you will throw your ring and say divorce. But God will give you the right partner that would stay with you forever. That's why we need to seek God and pray for the rest 3 days. It is enough that God will see you through. In the name of Jesus. I thank God for everyone. Thank you for coming. Thank you for joining. God bless you so much. Remember to join this prayer. It is very powerful. It will start midnight. Midnight tomorrow. So, 4 o'clock, there will be prayer. Midnight, there will be prayer. But prayer and fasting starting tomorrow midnight until Saturday. Thank you very much. God bless you. And remember to go to our website, www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca. Also, you can email us. Our email is overcomersdhm@gmail.com. Many people, they don't know this email. Sometimes they say, what? I say it is there on the website. The email is everywhere. overcomersdhm@gmail.com. Send me email. Send your prayer request. I will stand with you. Thank you very much. God bless you. Have a wonderful time. Bye. Bye-bye. God bless you. I love you. There's nothing I can do about it. Have a wonderful time. Bye-bye. Bye.